Let's create a serializer object for our API view. A serializer object is an object in the Django REST framework that we can use to describe the data that we need to return and retrieve from our API. It basically converts a text string of JSON to a Python object and vice versa. So let's create our first serializer, which we're going to use in our API view. Load up the Atom editor, and we're going to create a new file under our Profiles API app called serializers.py. It's best practice to store all of your serializers in a file called serializers.py. We're going to start by importing serializers from the Django REST framework. So type from REST underscore framework import serializers. This imports all the different types of serializers that we can use from the Django REST framework. We're going to create a new serializer called Hello Serializer. This serializer is going to have one field called name, and this field is going to be a char field, which is a character field. So create a new class called Hello Serializer and inherit from the serializers dot serializer object. So class hello serializer, serializers dot serializer object. We're going to give it a doc string of serializes a name field for testing our API view. Okay. And just like we did with the Django models, we describe the fields here as class variables. So create a new variable called name, and you give it a type, a field type from the Django REST framework serializers object. So just like the Django models, Django REST framework provides a bunch of different predefined fields that we can use for our API. One of these fields is called the char field, which is used to take character text input. So let's use the char field by typing serializers.char field. And we're going to give it the attribute max length equals 10. The good thing about the Django serializers is it has a lot of predefined validation in these character fields. So for example, this would check that we've entered a valid character field that has a maximum length of 10. If we provide a field that has, or we provide a name that has more than 10 characters, then it's going to give us an error message, but it's going to do all of that logic for us. So we don't actually have to check that ourselves. It will do all of it for us just by providing this parameter here, max length equals 10. Okay, so save the file. That's how you create a Django REST framework serializer. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next lesson.